What's going on, curious RV goers? Today we're going to answer the question of why is full body paint important to me? Okay, so before we talk about this very often asked question, go ahead, like this video, subscribe to our channel, turn on your post notifications so you can stay updated with all the latest and greatest, and make sure that you know what you're talking about when you're shopping for RVs. So, to answer the question, it's a little bit more, there's a little bit more explanation than just like, hey, is this important, is this not important? So, when people talk about full body paint, one, what is full body paint? And two, we'll answer why it's important to you. So, full body paint is a paint job on the outside of an RV that's like this. So, sometimes you can feel small bumps. Basically, the difference, you'll either have full body paint or you'll have decals that are just decals that are stuck on there with adhesive. So on full body paint, usually you can feel it's a little raised whenever you go over the different paint colors, but not like a true edge like you'll feel on the decals. And your salesman or salesperson will tell you this. That's, you know, unless they're dishonest, I don't know why they wouldn't, you know, be dishonest about something like this, but this, it's very obvious to tell if not. Like I said, rub your finger over, there'll be a little bit of raised if it's full body paint, and then a more of a real edge over a decal. So why is this important now that you know what it is? So it's important because full body paint's gonna cost you more money if you were, you know, in between a coach with full body paint and a coach with decals. So the full body paint will definitely cost you more. Why is it important? So it's important because over time, the elements take a number on any vehicle. It doesn't have to be an RV. It can be a car, a trailer, a boat. The elements take a toll on them. So when you have decals over time, your decals will fade. Eventually they can start to peel. And this can even happen if you take really good care of it. Now, how do you prolong the life of an RV with decals? As far as like the out exterior and that cosmetic look goes, well, you definitely want to wash it. After every trip, you get bugs on it. You don't want to ride it hard and put it up wet. You want to make sure you take care of it. So after you take a trip, at least wipe the bugs off and get it clean. And then I usually advise a lot of my customers, at least once every year, if you want to stretch it, maybe every year and a half, then every year to a year and a half, you want to get your RV waxed. Whether it's full body paint or just decals, I think it's a good practice either way. Now, this is more important when it's decals because you're putting a protective layering over it, which is that wax. That's going to keep the sun from baking it and making it oxidize or just making it really dull and faded looking, and then also hopefully keep your decals from peeling and cracking. Now, that's important to do. That will help prolong the life of an RV with decals. One with full body paint, again, it costs more up front when you buy it, but it does require less maintenance. So with the full body paint coach, I same advice I give to everyone. I do this with my vehicle as well. So I guess a little less with a vehicle than I would for the RV. So for your vehicle, you don't necessarily wash it all the time. Some people wash it once a week, which is probably a good practice, but you're mostly driving shorter distances in your vehicle, at least most of us do. In an RV, you're typically driving farther distances. You're hitting more bugs. You've got a bigger windshield. So basically it's getting, that you're taking longer trips. So it's getting more wear and tear on it, if you will, or just more bugs, to say quite simply, more bugs, more pollen, more dust. So it needs to be washed really after every use. And since even if you're using it every weekend, if you're using it every month, you want to wash it after you use it. It's very, very important to wash. And like I said, I'd probably get it waxed every year and a half, just to keep it looking good, put that protective coating on it to make it look better for longer. So we're going to show you here in a second a 2012 with full body paint that it doesn't have that much, you know, maintenance done to it. It wasn't like this guy, you know, babied it and scrubbed it with a toothbrush, but he did what he needed to do by washing it and basically this wasn't even stored under cover and it still looks this good. So we're going to show you that, and then I'll also show you, we're going to show you a 2012 with full body paint, and then I'll show you a 2016, so 4 years newer, with decals, and show you the difference that it makes. Okay, so this is a 2012 Navion. We'll do a video on this and, you know, here coming soon, so keep your eyes open for that. But this is a 2012 with full body paint, so it is dirty. I'm sure everyone in the country knows how much pollen has been around recently, so it is dirty with the pollen, but you can see how good this paint looks. It's not faded, and again, this guy did not do, you know, he didn't get out there and scrub it with a toothbrush all the time. He washed it and he took good care of it. Didn't even store it under a cover, but because it's full body paint, it doesn't take as much to keep it looking good. Your basic stuff, basically just caring for it, and you're good. I'm going to show you a 2016 that's a very nice coach, but wasn't stored undercover, and I'll show you what the sun does to the decals. So this is a 2016 with decals. So of course we picked the worst spot on it on purpose just to show you what can happen, but even you can see all of this. So this is 4 years newer than that 2012 I just showed you, and look how faded it is. Both stored outdoors, both. This one wasn't neglected by any means. I mean, this coach is not in bad shape. If you look at the interior and even the roof, you can tell that the previous customer did maintenance. They took care of it, but the sun just does a number on this thing. The sun and the rain just does a number. So you can see just the fading that it's done in a few years, how much worse a coach with decals looks compared to full body paint. So again, this is not a bad coach by any means. If you have a coach with decals, doesn't mean your RV is not nice or anything like that. This is just, again, we want to educate you as to why full body paint can be important. Now, they don't all peel like this. This could just happen because this is actually on the back of the refrigerator, your refrigerator cover. So it's actually plastic here. So that could be one reason why that peeled. But with a full body paint, you're not going to have this. So just something for you to know. Again, we want you to go and educate it whenever you're doing your RV shopping. So hopefully we taught you something today. If there are any questions that you have, even if you want advice, like you're looking at two RVs and you want to say, hey, I can't tell if this one has full body paint or doesn't, send it in to us. We'd be happy to help. So guys, we appreciate you stopping by. And as always, enjoy the journey. Hey there. Thanks for watching this video. So we want to remind you again to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and turn on your post notifications so we can keep you updated with the best that the RV industry has to offer. If you want to stick around and watch some more videos, we've got a link for two videos here. So we'd love for you to stay and look at that. And if there's anything else that you want us to do videos on, leave comments. Thanks, guys. Enjoy the journey.